In the cafeteria or up here, feel free to do so. We just ask that you, you know, not congregate, and then as well, of course, leave your masks on at all times. All right, I'm done spieling. Thank you so much. Enjoy the show.
But hey, welcome to our showcase tonight. My name is Maximo, and this is my assistant, Katie.
Oh, sorry about that.
COVID? Are you feeling queasy, loss of appetite, stomach problems, loss of sight?
You mean loss of taste?
Excessive need to correct other people. Difficulty breathing, brain damage, craving peanut butter?
Can I answer?
Fevers, chills, just feeling cold. Oh, height deficiency.
Okay. Who doesn't have a height problem?
Not me.
Well, anyway, as my secretary here was saying,
I could not be the secretary. I mean, I could not keep up with these changing schedules. Was today even a virtual day?
Yes, it was a hybrid day.
So it was a virtual hybrid day.
You see, the staff here prefer a more e-learning, self-paced type vibe.
Can I even come to school then?
Probably not, but check your emails tomorrow. It doesn't matter, it's all gonna change.
You know, it changes more than this bipolar weather. Oh,
yes, gotta love Mishawaka, Indiana. The constant construction really makes you want to get out and drive.
I love my trips around the city, especially when the roads, they're not even fixed.
You know what? Just stay inside. I watch The Mandalorian. Comfort of Baby Yoda I have.
I mean, imagine going outside and seeing a live performance. I mean, who does that anymore?
I know we have some audience members who remember those days, yeah.
Back in the 19th century?
Yes, where you could rip off your mask, and it didn't matter if you were hideous.
You know, Katie, that reminds me of my favorite musical.
Cats!
No. Something a little more sophisticated. The Phantom of the Opera.
I love that one! I dreamed a dream in time gone by.
No.
Oh.
It's the one that goes dun 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 dun, and it just repeats and repeats and repeats.
Yes! You know, the one with the huge parties, the fancy dresses, and the masks? Max, that kind of reminds me of our showcase tonight.
My show. Dear Katie, what a splendid party.
A crawl to a bright new year.
Quite a night, I'm impressed.
No one does what's best.
Here's to us.
A toast to all the city.
Such a pity that the Rona is to hear.
Masquerade, hide your face on the world of man. Masquerade.
that dandy.
Oh, the best. Well, welcome to our first annual showcase. It's like a test drive that was 2020.
Tonight's acts include singing, dancing, and acting.
All these students have been working extremely hard for the past 6 weeks to showcase. Come on, that was good. Their talents.
This first performance is a scene from a play called Almost May. The performers are Mahana Ashworth and Spencer Lawson, and was directed by Deb Swarman.
You're right.
What?
I'm just having a nice time with you, that's it.
I'm glad to know.
I always have a nice time with you.
I'm glad.
And the stars are just so... I didn't know you knew all this stuff. After all this time, I didn't know you knew all this stuff.
Well, it's not like I know that much about him. It's just, it's kind of something my dad taught me.
Hey.
Yeah?
I love you.
Well, I love you too. Oh! Oh, are you cold? Do you want to go inside? We could.
I just want to sit like this. Close. I feel so close to you, Night Pete. It's nice to be close to you. It's safe. I mean, I've been thinking of other ways to be close, but no, that's not what I mean. I just, right now, I think I'm as close to you as I can possibly be.
Well, not really.
What?
I mean, not really. If you think about it technically, if you're assuming the Earth is round like a ball, like a snowball, then the furthest point away from someone is if you're sitting right next to them. See, if I'm here and you're here, then that's far.
Yeah.
But now you're closer and closer. And closer, and closer, and closer, and closer, and closer!
Thank you. Bring out Boston 10, thou shalt abide.
Now she holds me not. Now try, if thou darest, to try whose right of thine and mine is most in Helena.
Try? Nay, I shall go with thee cheek by jowl.
You mistress! This coil is long of you!
Nay, we're not back.
I will not trust you, I, nor longer stay your cursed company. Your hands than mine were quicker for a fray. My legs are longer, though, to run away.
I am amazed and know not what to say.
Did any of you catch any of that?
Yeah, I have no idea what happened the last 5 minutes.
Well, actually,
No, I don't need you to mansplain things to me.
Look, I'm just trying to help you.
Thank you.
Can I at least introduce the next act? Here is a scene called Hold for Two. It is performed by Luna Butterfly, Tia Stopczynski, and Toby D. Smith, and was directed by Deb Strowman.
There, she's up!
This is ridiculous. You won't be able to hold his breath when the moon comes up. I'm like, can I just look at your watch? Okay. It is exactly 7:24 and 17 seconds.
Well, let's subtract 5 seconds to for operator error, shall we?
Why do I care, Scotty? Really?
Okay, now, Ed, the first 30 seconds are so easy. Just relax and save yourself.
Oh, you're weird.
Adjusted time from start.
23 seconds.
All right, okay. Now, Ed, I want you to imagine that you were in the movie of the week disaster film with Yvette Minot. You were underwater in a nuclear submarine. Yvette is trapped in a compartment where Polaris missiles are armed and ready to fly. You've got to hold your breath long enough to get in, rescue her, disarm 6 missiles, and save the world from a nuclear holocaust. You got that? Well, that ought to take him a while. Time?
He's never going to make it.
Oh, give me a break. It's almost a third of the way up.
A third? A third? His eyebrows just popped up.
The man in the moon does not.
Well, if he didn't, here come the eyes.
Time, damn it. Time, I got a man here trying to do a job.
53 seconds.
Okay. Ed, your hands right. 3 stormtroopers with boots pulsed to a shine hard that bounce laser beams into the room. You're hiding in a pile of dirty laundry. One breath out of you, and you'll feel the cold steel out of their bayonets. Not bad, huh?
He's turning blue.
Just that it's shaved this morning, that's
all. And he's shaking, I think.
I'd say it's about halfway, wouldn't you say?
Why is he shaking like that?
Oh, differences in the temperatures, the atmosphere flares. Something like that, I guess. It distorts the airwaves.
No, not the moon, Ed.
So he's shaking a little. Look, the bridge is up.
What?
Of the nose. Bridge is up, isn't it?
I hope he doesn't pass out or anything. What if he hyperventilates in reverse? What if he forgets how to breathe?
It took the genetic ancestors of Ed Carmichael billions and billions of years to learn to use their lungs. Even Ed can't scroll down in 3 minutes. Time?
1:33.
And the boy is sweating bullets. Okay, Ed, you're gonna love this. It's 1969. You're president of the university's SDS. The anti-war protest seems to be going on fine. With tear gas! The police are flapping with tear gas. One month out of you, and you're reduced to a slobbering flower child. You gotta hold your breath long enough to take over the dean's office. Go for it!
Time, 1:58.
Oh, we're getting into lips now. Come on, just a couple more, Ed. No, Ed, you can do it. Come on, pretend you're God. Yes, you're God. It's day one of creation, and you've got a whole world of things to make before. You go breathing the breath of life into Adam. So you hold it, Ed. You hold your breath for 5 days of creatures and firmament and shrubs. And only you can do it, Ed, because you're God. Time,
2:33.
Oh, the home stretch. Oh, we're getting into the home stretch now. You'll never guess what I say for the home stretch. You've been unjustly convicted of murder. It's just the gas chamber. You're locked in when new evidence about the partner of the gatherer. But the gas pellets have already been released. The guards are rushing to send you. If only you could hold your breath till. Oh, time!
2:44.
They're rushing to save you.
Clear the chin now.
You're almost at the door.
Just this much more to go.
Hold her at the door.
2 minutes and you can do it.
You're holding the door. Come on.
Time!
No, it's stuck.
9.
The guards are asking help from.
8.
The people in the press.
7.
The poor men are going.
6.
your breath. So impressive.
You should try being quiet for that long.
Is that a bet?
How much?
$15 at Snickers.
Deal. Oh, he's serious. Okay. Now that I have some time to talk, let me introduce you to the next act. This song from the hit musical Waitress features some amazing talents of... Eliana Stout, Kara Young, Marie Miller. Sorry, I got distracted. Mahana Ashbrook in, what is her name, Tiana? No, Taylor. No, that's not it,
It's Tia!
Ha! Pay up!
Please enjoy this next act while I pay up.
My mother.
know, Katie, I'm tired of all your negativity. I think it's time to brighten these poor people's spirits up.
I guess you could say that we want to shake things up, like in this duo dance by Cadence Radivar and Lorelei Hensel.
This dance was choreographed by their teacher, Jen Wolf, from Debbie Warbrook's dance studio.
I told you guys not to bring anything. I got you, Mom. There you go. Is there some kind of construction going on upstairs?
Oh, no, that's our neighbor. We think she stomps around or throws things, we're not sure.
Have you complained to her about the noise?
No, Dad, she's a 70-year-old Chinese woman.
Dad, I'm 61. Us older people are still able to process information. We're still able to...
I'm saying she's older and I don't want to disturb her, but I don't have to.
You can never come back! You can never come back, you can never...
Oh, you're all right. You're all right, Mom.
What is she saying?
Oh, she's... Even when she is saying real stuff, what's been coming out is still all...
This is Brendan's new apartment.
How are you, Mama?
We're going to have Thanksgiving at your granddaughter's new place. That sounds fun?
You can never come back. You can never come back.
Mama, you can come back absolutely anytime you want to.
Decent layout, Bridge. Good space.
It's really nice.
It's good, right? I can put my music workspace upstairs so I don't drive Rich crazy.
And this is a fancy chair. Hey, Eric, come check out this fancy chair.
I thought all your furniture was on the moving truck.
Oh, it is. Rich's parents gave us that. We don't know if this will be a living room or a bedroom.
I can't believe you ever downstairs.
Now, why would they give something this nice away?
Because they got a new window.
But you might want something even bigger for a shoe.
This isn't Scrooge, and we don't need an oversized recliner in every single room.
It's her latest phrase of the day. The doctor says it's normal, the repeating.
And, how is she?
She's still got a good age, you know. Yesterday she was pretty with it for the most part, but now she's... I don't know where she goes.
I tried to do her hair. I wanted her to look good, you know?
She does.
You guys should treat yourself to a spa day.
No, no way. Do you know how much that costs?
Well, you burn yourself out if you want.
Hey! Don't worry about us. Having her here with us until it becomes too much, it's a blessing, you know? Right, Eric? Eric?
Dad, come back to Eric.
Sorry. Long drive.
You okay?
Yeah, once I get some coffee in me, I'll be fine.
Hey, just went upstairs.
No, it's over.
You want me to call the super about the noise?
Dead. And now that he's dead, you fly in for the weekend and decide you want to help? You're late. Where have you been?
I was working 14-hour days. I paid every bill here. I paid off the mortgage on this 3-bedroom house while I was living in a studio in Brooklyn.
You had your life. You got to finish school.
You could have stayed in school.
How?
I would have done anything. I told you a million times. I would have done anything.
What about Dad? Someone had to be here to take care of him.
He was ill. He should have been in a full-time professional care situation.
He did not belong in a night house.
He might have been better off.
How could you?
Did he ever do any work again?
No.
No. You might have been better.
Better than what?
Living here with him didn't do you any good. You said that yourself. You had so much talent.
You think I'm like Dad.
I think you have some of his talent and some of his tendency toward instability.
Claire, in addition to scouting out the cute apartments that you found for me in New York, would you guys have any chance, given some of your considerable energy towards finding another type of living situation?
No!
Living situation for your bug house little sister?
No, that's not what this is about.
Don't lie to me, Claire. I'm smarter than you.
The resources, I investigated.
God.
All I'm saying is that the people and the doctors and
you. How could you?
You wouldn't have to live anywhere. You could just.
I hate you!
Please don't yell.
I hate you.
What a strong performance by two of our own senior class. Let's give them another round of applause. Now, as a representative of our senior class, I am so thankful to have this opportunity to be on stage again. It just makes this COVID feel just a little more normal in the small ways. Many of our seniors, as well as other students, have loved this opportunity to be on stage performing the numbers of acting or singing or dancing. And we'll have another opportunity to do this in our spring musical, The Wizard of Oz, which personally I think you should all come see as well. Theater gives us all a space to feel like ourselves. There is a certain safety and individuality in theater that just helps us all. And that's exactly what this next dance number is about. The next dance number is called This Is Me. It is from the movie The Greatest Showman. The dance is performed by Ashlyn Bailey, Katie Kruger, Katie Hartley, Natalie Baumgartner, Raylan Bryce, and Victoria Tiller, and was choreographed by Pia Burns. So, let's just hope and love this next dance number.
I'm a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want your broken parts. I'm learning to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. But
Hooray for a happy ending.
Oh, I love stories with happy endings.
You know, Katie, that reminds me of a musical with this big green ogre guy.
You know, I might have heard of that. Didn't he end up getting COVID?
Twice. You see, our spring musical,
The Show That Never Was,
was Shrek the Musical.
We are so thrilled and feel absolutely lucky to have the opportunity to perform some of the musical numbers from Shrek for you all tonight.
You'll see some of your storybook favorites, from Shrek and Fiona to Donkey and Dragon. We could not do this performance without the musical direction of Mr. Brown. And we have a special guest in our show, returning graduate Xavier Hartley.
On the piano, we have the rock of the music department, Mrs. Houck. And a special shout out to Mr. Chamberlain, who is playing an instrument that is only needed in Shrek, the fart machine. And now, without further ado, please enjoy this abridged version of Shrek the Musical, hashtag no COVID. Sorry about that, we're having a little technical difficulties backstage. So, like Katie did in during one of the scene changes, I'm going to try to tell some dad jokes. Just warning you right now, my sense of humor is kind of dry, so it's not really funny, but, you know, we can try, can't we? My absolute favorite one. Why did the chicken cross the road?
Why?
To get to the other side. It's a road and, you know? See, I told you I'm not that funny. Enjoy the show.
Birds and more.
cushy or pinky. I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom on the hour. Princess Lonely, walking in circles, I had only berries.
Thank you. don't care. And if you don't know that by now, then you need to get your eyes checked.
And you do it all, all right. But
and hallelujah.
Save a heart.